Thomas Weather.
The Rich Thomas Weather Network, brought to you by these fine sponsors. Hear Rich's forecast hourly on these Blue Water Broadcasting radio stations.
Hey, good morning, everybody, on this Monday morning. It is the 8th day of March. Time as I make this is a little bit after 4 o'clock in the morning, and it's a chilly 37 degrees. I don't think we're going to make it all the way down to freezing, but in a few communities, we'll come pretty close. But the chill will wear off quickly. We had upper 60s on Saturday and Sunday. I think we're into the low 70s today. And as you're going to see on this video, we are going to get warmer and warmer and warmer as the week goes on. Not only that, a storm-free period of time that is almost unprecedented in the month of March, because this is a very active weather month. How long will it last? We'll look ahead to what could be the next storm system.
The cold air that covered the east and especially the northeast over the weekend is retreating. That warm air in the middle of the country is starting to spread eastward, and I think we'll be well entrenched in through much of the eastern and especially southeastern U.S. as we get later in the week, and temperatures will continue to warm. Look at the above normal to much above normal temperatures covering much of the eastern half of the nation by the middle of the week. So for us, with high pressure now east of us, we start to pick up a little southeasterly breeze today. I think we warm up to about 71 for a high temperature after upper 60s for a couple of days on Saturday and Sunday. Tonight's low, not quite as chilly, overnight low of 40. So the winds shift around to the southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour, and the warm up continues tomorrow. I think we're easily in the low to mid 70s on Tuesday. I think we're in the upper 70s on Wednesday. That big high anchored off the U.S. coastline is not going anywhere. It's going to be staying in the same position for several days. So we get to 80 or above on Thursday, into the low 80s on Friday. Look at the high is still off the southeastern coast, much like the Bermuda high would be in the summertime. Saturday, not much change in the whole pattern. That's keeping storm systems at bay. So I've got us around 73 tomorrow after a morning low of 39. We'll be in the upper 70s on Wednesday, the lower 80s on Thursday and Friday. Even the nights are moderating. Lows in the 50s by Friday and Saturday. We'll put in a 20% chance of showers by Saturday night. But basically, I think we're storm-free till perhaps maybe early next week. The Ides of March. Looks like maybe showers and thunderstorms moving in. That would be part of a very active week. In fact, later in the week, there's another storm system, Thursday, March 18th. And I think we will get into an active pattern as that week goes on. But we're looking ahead, and we're looking and we're seeing no signs of any cold air. Are we done then with freezes? Well, let's take a look at some of those facts for you. And I realize on this graphic, there's a lot of information here, but this is the average date of the last freeze, March the 8th, today. Last year we had 17 freezes. This year, much more. It's been a much colder winter. 29 freezes so far. Last year we finished with freezes on the 28th of February. This year, the last freeze we've had so far is the 21st of February. Are we done? Well, the latest freeze ever, April 13th, 1940, and I certainly don't see any freezing temperatures in the next couple of weeks. So we'll see.
So, and again, keep in mind on that discussion about freezing temperatures that we are in the 30s this morning, and who knows, we could sneak close to the freeze mark. I don't think we're going to quite make it out at the airport, but we'll see. Hey, we're live on the radio this morning from 6 to 9 on News Talk 93.1, live on CBS 8 and ABC 32. Their morning program on the Alabama News Network is called Alabama Rising. That's always a fun get-together in the morning, and there'll be another video for you first thing tomorrow morning at 4:45 a.m. My video's a little more boring this week because there's nothing going on, but that's okay because the weather is going to be simply fantastic, and I hope you have a chance to get out and enjoy it. You can always hear my forecast on the Blue Water family of stations whenever you want it. Have a good day today, and I'll see you later.
Rich Thomas Weather.